Hello and welcome to Azure Vala YouTube channel. We are in part 20 of Microsoft Certified Associate series, and we have completed up to question number 44. We are going to see question number 45. So let's go. You recently created new Azure subscription that contains a user named admin1. Admin1 attempts to deploy an Azure Marketplace resource by using an Azure Resource Manager template. Admin1 deploys the template by using Azure PowerShell and receives the following error message: user failed validation to purchase resources. Error message: legal terms have not been accepted for this item on the subscription. To accept legal terms, please go to Azure portal, and this is the link, and configure programmatic deployment for marketplace item or create it there for the first time. You need to ensure that admin1 can deploy the marketplace resource successfully. What should you do? The question is very straightforward, and the error is self-explanatory, that there are some terms and conditions not being accepted for that particular item. So let's see. The option A: from Azure PowerShell, run the set AZ API management subscription commandlet. This command is actually being used to set the existing subscription detail. It has nothing to do with the terms and condition of a resource provider. So this is not the correct one. Option B: from the Azure portal, register the Microsoft Marketplace resource provider. This is used for registering new marketplace resource provider. So that is also not applicable in this case. From Azure PowerShell, run the set AZ marketplace terms. This is actually being used to set the terms and condition and accept or reject the terms and condition for a given publisher. So this is the correct answer. So C is the correct answer. Option D is: from the Azure portal, assign the billing administrator. This command is used for billing administrator. It has nothing to do with the resource provider. So that is also not. So we know the answer. Let's move to next question. Question number 46. You have an Azure Active Directory tenant that contains 5000 user accounts. You create a new user account named admin user 1. You need to assign the user administrator administrative role. So administrative role to admin user 1. What should you do from the user account properties? Okay, from the license blade, assign a new license. That is not for the license blade is not being used for assigning the roles. From the directory role blade, modify the directory role. Yes, this is the correct one. From the directory role blade, we can have the directory role modified or assigned. From the group blade, invite the user account to new group. This is not for assigning the role, it is just inviting for the group. So B is the correct answer, but still we will see on the Azure portal as well. So we are in our default directory, users, under the user 1. So we'll see for the user 1 here. We'll go scroll down. Not here, so we can see here group application Azure role assignment. Assigned role. Under the assigned role, we can have aid assignment, and under the aid assignment, we have resource default directory, resource type directory, and we can select the role, whatever the role we are looking for. So So this is how it is arranged for user 1, and then we can assign the role here. This is just for information. So here from directory role blade, we have seen that modify directory role, we can assign the role from here. Let's move to next question. Question number 47. You have an Azure Active Directory tenant named Contoso on Microsoft.com that contains 100 user accounts. You purchased 10 Azure Active Directory Premium P2 licenses for the tenant. You need to ensure that 10 users can use all the Azure AD Premium feature. What should you do? Okay, from the license blade of the Azure Active Directory, assign a license. Possibly this is the correct answer. So option A is correct, but let's see other options as well. From the group blade, for each user, invite group user to a group. Group has nothing to do with the licensing. From the Azure AD domain, add enterprise application. Application has nothing to do with the licensing. From the directory role blade of each user, modify the directory role. Directory role has nothing to do with the licensing part. So option A is the correct one, but still we will quickly see on the Azure portal itself. So we are in our Azure portal in Active Directory under users. We have selected user 1 and we would like to go to licenses, and we can go to assignment. Under the assignment, we can have this premium 2 license which we can select, and these all feature license we can add to this user account. So this is how the license assignment we can perform. I hope I was able to explain the question properly, and if you have liked this video, please press like button, subscribe to my channel and press the bell notification icon. Also please share with your friends. And see you next video. Thank you.